I kind of grew up in studios. And then a few years later, I was looking for a studio, and this one was, it'd gone bankrupt because they'd had a big flood here and it was torn apart except for the studios themselves. But it was a very famous studio and I knew that it was worth it because since it was built in the 60s, there's been more hit records out of here than any other studio in the world. It was like, how am I going to rebuild it? I can rebuild it like every other studio, or I needed somebody to kind of create a vibe here, you know? And I'd always been a big fan of Philippe Starck, you know? Philippe Starck kind of reinvented the hotel business. So he came over here and walked the place, and then he wanted to go for more of a kind of a very theatrical look for the studio rather than the sort of clinical look of most studios. When I started off in the industry, the techs used to wear white coats, you know? That was kind of how it was. And Abbey Road too. The vibe when you're working in this place is that you are literally standing in the same room that 50 years ago, Sinatra, Elvis and that were recording it. You definitely get a vibe when you're working in these rooms that a lot's happened here and a lot of good things have happened here. The history and the people that have been through this place and the music that they created is basically the soundtrack of our lives. This is the music we all grew up listening to.
Rolling Stones, Tom Petty, Red Hot Chili Peppers, Tool, Weezer, Muse. We've done a lot of work with Michael Bublé and Bob Rock in this room. Lovely, so, so nice. Ariana Grande actually plays this piano when she comes in. Yeah, yeah, there's so many.
Name any album, I guarantee part of it was done here, if not all of it. If you go back to the piano sounds of the 70s, and you have bands like Supertramp and Elton John and all the piano artists, the ones that had absolutely amazing piano sounds on their albums, like Crime of the Century was a Supertramp album that had probably the best recorded piano you've ever heard. I called him up, you know? I called up Ken Scott, because I didn't know what he used. And I said, how did you get that piano sound on those records? Because he also recorded Elton and a lot of the other people, Trident in the UK. He said, well, it was Bechstein. The mid-range of this piano is like no other piano. It just sings. It's got a harmonic structure to it like no other piano. And I think that was my original attraction to those great piano records that were made in the 70s and 80s that were used this piano. And so we decided this is the one that we wanted to keep in the studio. Broke my heart in the dark.
I was just trying to feel. Would the guys in Muse play it? Yeah. You know, did the people in Tool play it? Sure. It's both a pop piano, it can be a rock piano.
That's the story about the piano. It was a combination of my love of those early albums, tracking down who recorded them, finding out what he used. That's how this little baby came to be here.